we have presented the basics of the modern Spey cast in an earlier film, focusing on how to perform the underhand cast. In this video, we focus more sharply on details and provide some practical tips on different parts of the modern Spey cast. My first tip to improve your casting is optimize your anchor movement. You can do this by using only the first part of the pickup movement to place the part of the line to be anchored. The rest of the pickup movement you use to prepare for the forward cast by positioning the rod vertically and await the right moment to begin loading. This will give you time and control to conduct a calm and effective loading with focus on continuous acceleration of the pulley movement in a straight line towards your target. A recommendation is that you often have to begin loading the rod before the line has fully anchored. This requires early anchoring and then choosing the right moment to begin loading. If you wait too long, the line will get caught on the surface. Once again, an early and controlled anchor movement is the key to success. Finally, avoid large and long sweeping motions with your arms and upper body when you pick up the line to anchor it, as this often creates insufficient time for smooth and stress-free casting. Starting the forward cast with a vertically angled rod is important for creating the inner railway track and loading the rod in a straight line. This movement actually starts with your foot by pointing your so-called rod foot towards the direction you're going to cast. You create a straight line from the foot through the leg and upper body and your vertically positioned rod, and you now have a good starting point to begin loading of the rod. So try to get used to aim the rod foot at the angle you're going to cast, and you will get easier to load the rod in a straight line. This, together with the straight line on the anchored line, creates the so-called railway track, which are the basis for an effective Spey cast. Just when you start to load the rod, imagine that a tall, mysterious person attaches a little apple to your rod tip. This means that you will start your forward cast with this imaginary apple in place, and your goal is to get the apple to detach from the tip at the end of the forward cast and fly in a straight line, upwards and forwards, towards your desired target area. How do I do this? The most important thing is to pull the rod butt against you with an ever-increasing acceleration, starting slowly and continue to accelerate until the stop. If this is done correctly, the curved rod tip will follow a straight horizontal line and the apple will detach from the rod tip and fly straight towards the target when stopping the rod. Of course, there is no actual apple flying. It's the tight loop of the fly line traveling fast towards a soft, delicate touchdown. A common mistake is incorrect loading of the rod. Instead of starting slowly and accelerating continuously, you pull too fast at the beginning of the loading moment. This lowers the rod tip at the beginning of the forward cast, which, consequently, will not follow the vital straight line. This makes the apple prematurely fall off the rod tip, in reality causing a bad forward cast, usually a tailing loop. Another common error is the rod is not positioned in a stationary and vertical position when starting the load for a forward cast. This means that the rod tip will still rotate after you have completed your anchoring movement, and you start the pull motion too early. The result is often a tailing loop or an inefficient shaped loop. A tip to minimize this problem is to use medium or fast action rods instead of rods with softer and deeper action. A typical error for all types of Spey casts is to miss time when to begin loading the rod for the forward cast. If you start too late, the cast simply collapses. If you start too soon, not enough fly line attached to the surface and the rod cannot be optimally loaded. Again, the cast collapses. A tip: the line should just kiss the water and be as silent and gentle as possible, with as little splashing of water surface as possible. A perfect anchor is like a silent kiss.